Hello friends, welcome to the next session of cooperative learning. We are going to discuss the technique peer instruction. So what is peer instruction? It is the active learning strategy which is based on specific well-designed question. So how to carry out it? Here teacher pose one question and with four answers. He provide four options as answer and voting is taken for his question. First student give individual response and then they turn to their partner. They discuss in pair. After discussion, again voting is taken and see the difference in voting. Now they may form a group. In the group, they discuss and again the voting is taken and again the large, on the large scale or the full class discussion is taken and again the voting is conducted till we get the common consensus as 100% against 0. So that we'll get one final answer. So for example, I am from physics. Therefore, I will give you the example from physics. The question posed is, how many axes of symmetry are there in cubic system? And the four options are provided. Now, students will give the voting. Some may say, option 1, option 2, option 3 or option 4. Then, there is discussion in pair and again, there is a group discussion and again, class discussion. So, how to take the voting? We may use clicker. Many times clickers are not available in the class. So, it doesn't mean that we do not conduct peer instruction activity without clicker. So, thus we want to take the voting. So, students may use the hand. Option 1, they will say like this. My answer is option 2. We may say like this. Option 3, option 4, like this you can give the voting or you can use a piece of paper, write your option number and you show it like this. This is your answer. Okay. So, you can conduct this activity without clicker and you can take the voting. So, when we take the voting, we get different responses. Then, teacher will ask for every response. The students who say option 1 is the answer, they have to give justification and they have to convince the class why option 1 is correct. Similarly, we do it for option 2, option 3, option 4 and in this manner we come to common consensus and then we get the final correct answer. So, after discussion, we come to final correct answer. So, one thing, very important thing, it happens here that one by one, we eliminate wrong answers. We discuss why option 1 is wrong. We discuss why option 3 is wrong. Why option 4 is wrong. And thus, why option 2 is the correct answer. And thus, it helps to enhance the depth of understanding. The key element of peer instruction is the effective question. Which question we call as effective? It must be conceptual. It should not be long question, descriptive question or analytical or computational. It elicits pre-existing thinking. There cannot be ambiguity. Two options at a time cannot be correct. So, you cannot take the voting properly. And it should not be trivial. It's very simple. The question should be such that it needs the students to apply their knowledge. When can we conduct this activity? In the beginning, to motivate the students to participate in the learning process or to assess the students about their prior knowledge, what is the prerequisite of that module. During the lecture or in the module of the middle of the module also we can conduct to evaluate their application and analysis, and at the end of module to assess the overall learning process and to take the review from the students, we can conduct this activity. What are the challenges of cooperative learning? In the previous video, we have seen the technique think, pair, share. This is the peer instruction. Seeing both these techniques are in overall group activity. When we conduct group activities, some challenges we face. The first challenge we face, students do not participate. They are reluctant to participate in the activity. So be patient. In the beginning, it may happen, but you keep the consistency and after few sessions, you may see the involvement of the students. Few students participate, they are aggressive, they are enthusiastic, but the some students, they are lacking of a confidence and they are shy and hence they do not participate. As we discussed in the earlier videos, the role of teacher is very important. He has to convince the students the importance of these sessions, how these sessions would affect their teaching learning process and benefit their personality, and he must design very interesting question. Sometimes the class become too noisy. Don't worry, it is very good sign, but here you have to ensure the engagement of students in the discussion. For that, you walk through the class, see how the groups are discussing, which points they are discussing, so you can monitor the class behavior or the group behavior. And many times the whole group becomes chaotic and we feel that there is no control over the class. So in that case, we use some cue like clapping. You clap like this. So this, when the students see you clapping, they will get the hint and they will pay the attention to you and it is under control. Or you can use cooperative quiet signal. If it is becoming too noisy, just you put one of your finger like this and your left hand like this, raise your left hand like this. This we call cooperative quiet signal. As soon as students look at you, they see you that you are giving this signal, the students themselves will give this pause and the whole class will be under control. So though there are challenges, we can overcome the challenges and we can come out with some new strategies, innovative techniques of cooperative learning. Thank you very much.